In this video, we'll look at 6 hard surface techniques that changed how I worked. I've been creating 3D work professionally for like 20 years now. That is to say, I have come across my fair share of hard surface challenges. In this video, I'm going to share some of my top techniques that I wish I had known years earlier and that have saved me hours and hours of frustration. Hard surfaces usually feature a lot of flat surfaces with right angles, mainly due to the not overly malleable materials involved. I'm thinking things like metal, wood, and plastic. However, these things can still be bent, cut, and molded into curved shapes. Let's take this design for example. Now, we could start with a very high poly mesh, but what we gain in resolution, we lose in control, even with proportional editing. So let's look at keeping this mesh density super low and controllable while having this high resolution smooth outcome. Okay, so let's move this one aside, and I'm just going to shift and right click to drop the cursor and shift A cylinder. And we only need about 16 vertices here. Jumping into edit mode, let's just scale along the Y. Something like that looks good. And in poly select, let's do the top and bottom. I to inset. And then right click, bridge faces. Let's just move it out of the way a little bit. There we go. Now we have some larger bevels here. So let's just go into edge mode, select these, bevel. That looks good. Maybe let's increase it a tad. And one on the inside here, and bevel. Cool, that looks good. Now for the front section here, we can select these group of polygons, like so. Hit E to extrude out, scale down along the Y. Let's move it back a little bit. And then, assuming you have loop tools enabled, which you may need to do so from the add-ons menu in the preferences, we can right-click, loop tools, circle. I'm just going to scale that down, hit extrude, inset with I, and then one more extrude to go in. Okay, we have roughly the same shape, but with very low polys. Now let's look at how we can make it nice and smooth, but with hard edges. Firstly, let's add a sub-D modifier with Control and 3. We have the smooth down, but not the hard edges. So let's go into edit mode and let's select one of the edges in edge mode. And we can use Shift-G and then face angles to select edges with the adjacent faces at a certain angle, which we can dial in here. But that looks good to me. So let's Shift and E to create the crease. Looks good. We need a few more creases here. So again, let's select that edge, face angle, and Shift E. Okay, cool. Now we also have a couple more edges here that we need to select to match this style. And underneath, we don't have any sharpness at all. So let's just select that edge loop with Alt, Shift E again, and reduce to nothing, and just make sure that is -1. I'm just going to move this edge up a little bit to match. Okay, cool. Now we have the nice sharp edges. So let's just shade smooth and see what we've got here. Just going to hide all of the wireframes with Alt, Shift, and Z to switch off the overlays. It's looking okay, but it's not quite as nice and creased as this one. So let's add a bevel as well. Go into edit mode, select one of the edges with a crease on, and then if we Shift and G, we can select all of the creases, and then Control and E, edge bevel, and we'll just add an edge bevel weight of 1. Now we can add a modifier, search for bevel, limit method to weight, that weight we just created, shading, hard normals. Now if we switch off our overlays, we have a really nice look with nice sharp edges. Let's say you're being a productivity wizard and you're only working on half of your model, knowing that you can add a mirror modifier. If we were to do so now, you can see that we have odd pinching here and it's not looking particularly nice. And this is because our mirror modifier is happening after the fact. Thankfully, there's quite a cool way that you can remedy this. And that is because as of 4.2, you can pin modifiers. So if we select bevel, for example, we can pin to last, and likewise on our subdivision. Now, if we add our mirror modifier, it happens before our pin items in the stack. Really handy. Now, this one took me far too long to realize. I'm sure a lot of you know that you can add cables by going into a curve, adding, say, a Bezier curve, going into the curve options and geometry under depth, just cranking things up a little bit like so. However, I used to then go in and start manipulating these points and try and snap and rotate and arrange things, and it just took a little bit too long. And I find it considerably easier to just select all and delete all of the vertices, jump in to the draw mode, and draw from the cursor. Now if we go into orthographic here, I'm just going to snap the side. Let's go to wireframe. We can draw the curve that we want. Something like that looks good. And you can see that the calculation of the Bezier handles is already pretty good and only needs a little bit of cleanup to finish. On a side note, you can also go into edit mode and just check surface, and now you can draw your cables all over your geometry and it sticks nicely to it like so. Right angle joins like this appear quite a lot for me, particularly in hard surface modeling for handles and the like. Thankfully, it's quite easy to put together. If you have your two cylinders here in place and they are joined into one object, we can select the edges here, right click, and then go to bridge edge loops. And then under number of cuts, you can add, say, 5, and then adjust the smoothness factor to your liking. And done. Some things are just painful to add to existing geometry without having to seriously mess up your beautiful underlying base mesh. So why not just stick it on top? Well, let's look at how to set that up. Firstly, this is the item we want to stick on the underside of our craft here, just like a pulse engine of sorts. Firstly, we need to make sure that our origin point is snapped to the bottom. So I'm just going to go into edit mode, edge select the loop with Alt and left click, and then snap our cursor to it with Shift and S. Hitting Tab to go back out into object mode, we can go to Object, Set Origin, Origin to 3D Cursor. Now under our snap options here, we can make sure we are on face and align rotation to target. And that affords us the ability to just hit G, hold down Control, and snap our item on the underside like so. Now this isn't hugely convincing as a join here, but we're only just getting started. So to make it a little bit more convincing, we can go into edit mode and select these outer polys, go over to our vertex options, create a new vertex group. Let's just leave it called group and then click assign. Now if we jump out into object mode and move over to our modifiers, we can add a new modifier and search for shrink wrap. Let's move it to the top of the stack. Now we can select our target, the main base of the ship here, and restrict this effect by that vertex group we just created. Now we can duplicate this over the bottom to our heart's content. Now I'm sure some of you can see that the join here is still quite abrupt, particularly in rendered mode, and it's not really fooling anyone. Thankfully, we can use the normal data from the object which we are stuck to and apply it to this object. And to do so, with the object selected, we can go Add Modifier, search for Data Transfer, select our source object, and go down to Face Corner Data. Let's just expand that, and we want the custom normals. And the option we want is Nearest Face Interpolated. And I find this to be the smoothest result. And as you can see, it looks like it almost doesn't exist at all with some very light shading. Thankfully, we can once again take advantage of our vertex group to isolate the effect. And now you can see, particularly compared to the old method, it looks considerably better. So let's just shift select all of the remaining items and then the item with the data transfer, and then go to this little drop down here and copy to selected. Excellent. I hope some of these techniques have helped. Now, this model was built exclusively to demo most of these techniques, but if you had fun and you'd be interested in learning something a little bit more, then you might like Robotic Planet, a full robot creation course over at CG Boost Academy. We walk through entire robot creations, as well as tackling even more tips and tricks. Enrolling in the course also gives you access to the CG Boost community, where you can comment, share ideas, or get help on particular parts of the course. I hope to see you there.